Hi, I'm Jessie Jane Duff, United States Marine Corps retired gunnery sergeant, and I'm with the London Center, senior fellow with the London Center for Policy Research. Well, he's withdrawing. We have 2,000 special operators that are there right now supporting the Kurdish operation. And apparently they'll be moved into Iraq and based out of there. However, 200 are going to be left behind. I think this is a fabulous deterrent to the Russians, the Syrians, the Iranians, and the Turkish people that have no good intentions towards the Kurds. As long as those 200 operators are left behind, it gives a small presence of the United States, but that small presence is very powerful because it says the Kurds are our allies. It says we're there to support the YPG and we're still there to support the Syrian Defense Forces against any potential rise against ISIS, but also to ensure that they are not attacked, brutalized, murdered without any effort by the United States to help defend them. I think that this is a region that is very, very important for the Kurdish people. You know, the Euphrates River region, it's an agricultural region, oil. It's also a gateway into Iraq. So many of the enemies that we have want their claws into this region. And I think that the Kurds have every reason to buckle down and resist all of this insurgency that you're seeing from the Iranians that are trying to support the Syrian government, supporting the Russians that would definitely love to have their hands into that, and along with Erdogan, who's an enemy of the Kurds. So hopefully with all of this, the Kurds will at some point under this president be able to have their own state without international interference.
Did nothing.
You know, the U.S. often is in a very precarious position for getting involved when they're in the Middle East. For example, we have 50 allies that the president went to last May, Muslim Arab countries, and asked for their support against this Islamic extremism that has destroyed lives, including those of the Kurds. And how many have stepped up to the plate? Has Jordan stepped up? Has Saudi Arabia stepped up? Has UAE stepped up? Has Egypt stepped up? We are in a region that we don't even live. And those that are in that region are doing nothing. So I understand and appreciate criticism of the United States when maybe we're not pushing forward as much as we should to support the Kurds. I've always been very, frustrated, particularly with the Obama administration when the Kurds were not getting the support they needed. At the same time, Americans are so war weary of no fault of the Kurds, no fault of them, because of Afghanistan and Iraq. I mean, we're talking over almost two decades now that we've been over there trying to fight something with not much support from our own Arab allies. So we're often stuck in a rock in a hard place, because if we come out bombing everything and blasting everything, the international community lashes out at us and claims, why are you involved? But we do know the Kurds are our allies. We do know that the Kurds are our friends. And I hope that with this, with the 200 troops left behind, I really hope behind the scenes there's far more left behind that are helping. I hope that there's those that may not be in your uniform. Some of our undercover people, some of our operators are there. Hopefully we have CIA that's involved, because we want people on the ground to ensure that the Kurds succeed, because their success is a success for humanity. It's a success for freedom. It's not a success for the United States. It's a success for the world.